Hi, I'm Julia.
And I'm Isabella.
And today we're going to be teaching you how to put in a tampon.
So when was the first time you wore a tampon? Like, what was that experience like?
So I had tried a few times, but then I had my bronze cross test and I knew it was time. Like, I was having a heavy flow moment and I knew I couldn't wear a pad in the water. Mm. It was too much. So it was like me alone in this pool, like change room, just like literally like pep talking myself like I was about to go into like the ring to fight. And then I just put her up there, really committed. How about you?
I didn't wear a tampon until like pretty late in my period journey because no one taught me how and I was too scared to try.
Yeah.
So then in my early 20s, surprise I'm not a teen, I just forced myself to do it because I was like over the pad moment. And that's not to shade a pad moment. I love a pad moment, but sometimes you need a tampon moment. So I just took a mirror, shoved it in, and the rest is history.
So now that you've gotten to know us, it's time to introduce
our friend, the vagina. What should we name her?
Ooh, I always called mine the vajayjay or the nether region. What did you call yours?
George.
Stunning.
Stunning. Let's go. Before we teach you how to insert a tampon, we're gonna go over the basics of what's going on down there. What's going on underneath the hood? Juliet, take it away.
Yeah, so we got some of the classics. We've got your clitoris up here. We've got the labia majora and the labia minora. There's those two little guys down there that you'll feel. And then we have the vagina right here. So that's the opening. And then this little dot up here is your urethra. So that's where you pee. Fun fact, where you pee and where you have your period, two different things. You can pee while you have a tampon in, and that took me many years to learn,
We have three holes. One for pee, two
for period, for babies.
For period and babies, and your butthole.
The classic.
The classic. Okay, so Julia.
Yeah.
You are going to teach us a masterclass in how to put a tampon in.
For sure.
Perfect. Let's go.
First and foremost, there's a couple different kinds of tampons you can do. You've got like the big one, you've got the little condensed one, and then you can have like a OB or like a non kind of container one without the applicator. So I'm gonna do the condensed one because I remember this was really popular when I was in high school. It's super discreet, it's small, you can put it in your pocket, you don't really have to worry about it. So we're gonna open her up.
Okay.
And then you're gonna need to actually pull this out a little bit and then you'll hear a little click. I don't know if you heard that.
Ooh, that was good. Oh, that's like ASMR.
Yeah, oh yeah. I love ASMR. So now that you have your applicator fully extended, this is gonna be the part that sits outside of your body to start. So you're gonna wanna like put your leg up or you can do like a squat, whatever is most comfortable where you feel like you're gonna be able to kind of get access to your body. And don't be scared of it. If you gotta get in there and touch around a little bit and figure out where's what, go for it. So you're gonna wanna move your labia minora and majora out of the way. You're gonna open that up and then you're gonna insert the tampon right inside your vagina. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna, what I like to do is you can have two fingers on either side, whether it's like this or like this. And then once this part is inside of your vagina, this like main section, the applicator is sticking outside, so then you're going to get a nice firm grip and you're gonna use the applicator to push the tampon into place. And then kind of the walls of your vagina will hug the tampon and you'll be able to pull the applicator out.
It's that easy.
It's that easy.
So, to clarify, which hole?
The vagina.
So, now that the tampon has been inserted into your body, here are some signs that you did it right. Because sometimes it could be kind of hard to know.
Yeah,
sometimes once it's up
really
there,
hard.
It's like, is it in? Is it not? Did it get lost?
Yeah.
Where is it? Where is she?
Yeah. So I think kind of a good first thing is like, can you feel it? If you can feel it kind of sitting, especially around this section of your body, like outside of your body, you know it probably needs to go in a little bit further.
Yeah, one of the things that happened to me when I first started wearing a tampon is if I sat down with it and I really felt it, I knew it was time to go back into the bathroom and just shove it up there just a little bit more, just so it was comfortable.
Yeah, and if the applicator has obviously already been thrown out, you can just use your fingers to push it a little bit farther inside your body. There's nothing wrong with that.
nothing wrong with that. Just make sure your hands are clean. Yeah. So it really is as simple as that, but we do have a few little tips and tricks and secrets to make sure this process goes as smoothly as possible. So the biggest thing to remember is always wash your hands. You're gonna be, really feeling around there, especially if it's your first few times.
Yeah.
And, you know, it could be a little hard fumbling with these the first time. If you drop it on the floor, if it gets a little messy, just throw it out and try again. You could grab another one from the box. We want to make sure everything is as clean as possible.
One other tip or trick is definitely take your time with this. Find a Saturday or a Sunday where you've got nothing going on. See if your mom's home or if you have an older sister or aunt, anyone that you trust. Hey, if your dad's cool, ask your dad. My dad was a little weird about it, so I asked my mom. But yeah, take your time with it. Don't be afraid to use multiple tampons. It takes time. It's taken us time. You're not alone in that. So you got this. We believe in you. Just try. Our final tip on how to wear a tampon is how to avoid that dry tampon feeling.
Ooh.
Right at the beginning of your period or right at the end, you're not bleeding enough to kind of have a tampon in long enough for it to fill up with blood, and you don't want to leave your tampon in too long because of toxic shock. So we have kind of the ultimate solution. If you can wear your Knixteen at the beginning or the end, you kind of avoid having to manage a tampon that might be dry and you might not fully need it. This is actually exactly where I am in my cycle right now.
Ooh.
And I was actually so glad to have a pair so I don't have to worry about a tampon when I know I don't really need it, but I'm also not fully done my period and you don't want to leak through because we all know that's no fun. Look at that.
Wow, super absorbent. Okay.
And then this
are you wearing yours today?
A beautiful star print? How could you not?
Are you wearing yours today?
I am.
Which color?
I'm wearing black. It's a classic.
So boring. Go with these ones. Oh, they look cute.
Star print.
Oh, star print. Oh, we love the star.
We love the star. Print. Who's the star you are?
Oh my god, you are.